Today is Tupac Shakur's birthday. Did you know that? So we've been pretty old, like me. Tupac's from my day. He's my favorite rapper growing up. And I still listen to Tupac. I think he's a great artist, musical artist.
Yeah. There you go.
Anyway, that's our show. Hey guys, it's your best five friends. I'm Kelsey. That's Rachel. Our show today is about Rachel the Lioness.
We recently just saw Amanda Nunes totally, completely dominate Felicia Spencer. And then in an interview with, I want to say, Esporte Espectacular.
What's
I don't know.
something like that? Yeah,
It was in
Portuguese. She's in
Portuguese.
Brazil. She's
Yeah.
considering retirement
I
because
can't hear the interview, but it sounded like to me that there was a conversation and asking about like maybe her future, you know, where do you see yourself, you know, next 5 years as a UFC fighter or something? And she's like, you know what? I'm not sure. She expressed some doubts. She feels like she's done everything in the division. And I have to kind of agree with Amanda Nunes.
Yeah, what else is there to
I'm
do?
like, what is this lady supposed to keep doing? Like,
And
you
she's
know?
not 27, you know. She's, I
Yeah.
figure, I think she's 35. She's old enough where I was like, oh, she could retire. Like, she could just be like, you know what? I did everything I want to do. I'm already the best ever. And the other people that could have maybe been the best ever, I beat them inside the octagon. So now
And then
I'm.
by when she beat Felicia Spencer, she had like another kind of
Yeah,
history-making
she
thing to
became the
do.
only champ to defend both title belts while still being the double champion.
Yeah. And so like I don't know when you're kind of
What else is there to do?
when that's becoming like the thing you fight for, I see that you're running out of things. You know what
Yeah,
I
so
mean?
she
To
might just want to
accomplish.
deliver a life now. And that shocked UFC President Dana White. It was really good because I watched it. It was from the Schmoes podcast. I think it's called the Schmo Zone. Anyway, they're basically rapping with Dana White for like 30 or 45 minutes, and in the
Yeah.
middle of it, they ask him, "What about this Nunes thing?" And Dana had no idea; he had not seen it or
Dana
heard
had
it.
not seen the news yet that Amanda Nunes had
Yeah, so it
thrown out
completely
there.
shocked him, and so
He was like, "Say what?"
which is a hard thing, right? Because he just is dealing with Henry Cejudo's retirement, Conor McGregor's retirement, Jon Jones and Jorge Masvidal want out of their UFC contracts; they don't
Yeah.
want to fight. So now you're saying the fifth one? That's a lot of star power, and I
Yeah.
think finally we see that it's starting to wear on Dana White because, otherwise it seemed he kind of he'd been taking all these things in stride, but now he's like, "What?
Being like, yeah, well, if
this
you
is
need
getting
to take care of
difficult."
yourself, yeah. And I like what he said in this, is he said, you know, usually what I say when a fighter talks about retiring, then it's time for you to retire. He goes, but not in this case.
Yeah.
He was like legitimately like he wants Amanda Nunes in the women's division. Like it's really important to him, is what it
Yeah.
sounded like.
I think the good of Amanda Nunes retiring would be that it would open up the division, two divisions potentially. I don't know if the UFC would keep the featherweight division. They created it for specifically for Cyborg and said they would keep it going for Nunes. But at least one division would open up for people to win titles. There's a lot of talented fighters there who just don't happen to be as good as the greatest female fighter ever. Obviously, the bad part of her retiring is that Amanda is retired and we don't get to see her anymore. And she's seems to
Well,
have plenty of
yeah.
left in the tank.
And here's for me. Yeah, I would love to see Amanda Nunes continue to fight, but I want to see Amanda Nunes fight legitimate, like people that are up to her level. I want to see great
Well, she's
competition.
already done that, though. I
I
mean,
know.
there's
So
nobody
that's what
there.
I'm saying is I'm not sure that I want to see Amanda Nunes continue to fight and just totally dominate, like where she's the clear favorite every single time out of the gate. Like
Yeah.
I'm not sure I'm interested in that. So what you're saying is what I hear you saying is Amanda Nunes retires and then the division starts to look
Well, it's
like
competitive.
more competitive because I think it is hard. It's hard for me to be like, okay, here's the top person that nobody can beat. Well, now let's just have these other fights. I don't know, it's hard for me to really go all in on those other
Well, it's
fights.
good for the other fighters. I know it's hard for us fans, but it's good for them because, I mean, honestly, Felicia Spencer has a chance to win the featherweight title. That doesn't include Amanda Nunes and Chris Cyborg
Right,
being
right.
back.
So that's what I'm saying. It's the title. When if with Amanda there, even though these other, you know, 10 fighter, whatever, five fighter, they can be competitive with each other, it's kind of like, eh. Because there's no nothing to
Yeah.
win.
Well, you
What are
don't
they?
want to
They're
lose the
fighting for
stars.
like
Well, they get the UFC gold, baby. They get it wrapped
but
around their waist.
you want them to be able to have the title. The title does make it like something.
Yeah.
Me just seeing competitive fights, it's great, but that extra like drama, Yeah, so I can't really argue with Amanda. I know it sucks. You know what I mean? Like it sucks. But this happens in women's in boxing has happened as well, where they can very quickly clear out their divisions because there is less competition in the women's
Yeah.
field. So they'll kind of
And
do
even in
everything
boxing,
and
it's a lot
then
less
yeah,
than
it's
there
been
is
a
in the
lot
UFC.
less. So like they
Clarissa's fighting all over the place. She's fighting whatever weight she can find the title belt at
right.
because she doesn't have enough competition in
There's
one
not enough
weight class. She's got
competition.
to move around,
Which
up
is
and
why
down.
Clarissa Shields is even
Yeah.
like even mentioned. It even came out of her
She wants
mouth
to fight Amanda Nunes.
to come over to MMA. But I mean, we've talked about it before. It'd be a huge learning curve for her, and she'd have to spend a lot of time and really go be 100% in,
Yeah.
like Holly Holmes was. I'm not sure with the kind of star power Clarissa has in boxing that she could legitimately do that, because I think she'd be at the bottom of the pile for a little while, you know?
Yeah, I don't know how that would work. I know that if she really committed to it, she could definitely be successful at it, but it would take, it's not just like you can jump over there and suddenly know jiu-jitsu. That's not how it works. It would take
Yeah.
years, just like Holly Holm had to learn,
But I mean
a great boxing champion, Holly Holm.
the depth of field is so shallow in women's boxing that
Well,
Clarissa
it's getting better.
Shields hasn't been professional for very long, and we're already like, what
Who's she
else is
gonna
she supposed
fight?
to do?
And the
Like, I
people that you
mean,
want to see her fight, well, like, Kay Taylor's probably too small. You know what I
yeah.
mean? Like, there's people around that you're like, well, that's, I don't know if that
They're
fighter can
having to
make that
make
fight.
like almost unjustifiable catch weights, you know? So I get it with Amanda Nunes, and I just like gotta be honest, like I agree with her, and it kind of sucks. But yeah, and it sucks for Dana White to be the last to
But we
know.
also don't know. She's not like Nunes has made her decision. She definitely could come back. She seems like
Yeah,
she's
she
thinking
hasn't
about
made
it.
a decision.
So I hope that we see her back, but I don't know. It's been a really, really weird, really weird year. What I do know is this is the year of real talk with Kelsey and Rachel. You know, we consider ourselves your best fight friends, and I think that you consider us that too. So be sure to like, comment, and subscribe for all the best combat sports talk and opinions and nonsense that we throw at you each and every day. Well, usually Monday through Friday.